Alistomania. Think less but see it grow.
Hello everybody, it's the Law Gnome, and welcome to your November 2019 episode of 10 for 12. If you're new to my channel, let me just say welcome. It's a pleasure to have you, and I'm really excited to give you guys another great top 10 list. And today, I guess you could say, in celebration of the release of Disney Plus, I mean, I have no intentions of getting it myself at this point in time, nor do I even care for it. I actually have a massive vendetta against any possible streaming service, but that's another topic for another time. If you want to discuss that with me, you're welcome to on Twitter or in the box below. But we're going to be celebrating Disney today because we have been celebrating Disney on my channel for many years, whether it's in the Out of the Vault series or by 10 for 12s. We have done so many Disney-themed topics, and today we are sort of creating the culmination here. We're going to be finally talking about our top 10 favorite Disney canon animation classics and the heroes that are part of them. So, I just want to let everybody know, before I begin with my top 10 list, besides the fact that I've got two excellent collaborators whose channels and videos will be in the box below, I cannot put my favorite Disney classic of all time on this list because it's really not a story with a hero. And that, of course, is the third animated classic from 1940, Fantasia, which was actually the first Disney classic I ever reviewed on Out of the Vault as well. So the fact that I reviewed my favorite Disney classic says something. But there's no necessary heroes in there. I mean, could I say the music? Not necessarily, because it's not really much of a hero, but I did, however, give you guys my 10 favorite Disney canon classics, and I'm ranking them on my personal favorites from 10 to 1, as well as the heroes who are part of them. Another one that I have to give honorable mention to is the 1973 classic Robin Hood. That was one of my all-time favorites when I was growing up, but he unfortunately has gone below the top 10 list in recent years, because let's face it, with the second Disney Renaissance, we have gotten some incredible films, and especially being the completionist that I am, watching all of these great Disney canon classics, some that I had never even seen before, my list has definitely changed. So, thank you very much to my collaborators who are joining me. Let's begin with our 10 favorite Disney canon classics and their heroes. So, number 10 is Aladdin. Now, Aladdin was one of my all-time favorites for so many years, of course, because of Robin Williams voicing the genie, but we're here to focus on Aladdin himself. Aladdin is definitely a character that young boys can look up to, because there weren't that many male leads that most boys really love, when, especially when you take them alongside all the Disney princesses. But Aladdin was a guy who really was looking out for himself, but he also really cared about other people. And it took him a little time to figure it out, but with the help of the people that were around him, also some creatures, they definitely told him that he is more than just himself and just a street rat. He really is a good and kind soul. And the movie itself is just entertaining, flat-out fun, great animation and music, and like I said earlier, when Robin Williams is the voice of the genie, how can you lose? Number 9 is Big Hero 6. Now, Big Hero 6 is a film that I'm starting to get more appreciation for, especially considering the fact that the animated series, which has just finished its second season, is absolutely fantastic. But Hero is another character that so many people can relate to. He's a young boy who suffered a major loss, and he has tried so hard to find a way to do justice for his brother, and sometimes he finds out the hard way that it's not necessarily about revenge, it's rather standing up for those who can't find justice and be the great hero that you are. The movie itself, beautifully animated, absolutely hysterical. The whole cast of characters truly makes this movie. And once again, you have to see the animated series because they're really developing and expanding on these characters even more so. If they ever made a sequel to this film, I really hope that they take it back to where the animated series finishes at that point in time and expand upon it through a second film that way, because that would be the best thing to do. Number 8 is The Rescuers. And yes, you can throw The Rescuers Down Under into this slot as well, because it's pretty much the sequel to a story that we've already seen before. And the heroes, Bianca and Bernard are probably two of the most genuine classic heroes that we have ever seen. And they can show you that being small is only size. It doesn't mean that if you have a big heart, you cannot do great things. And the fact that these two characters go out on a mission that the human world can't even seem to figure out, they manage to defeat impossible odds and rescue Penny from the evil Madame Medusa. The film itself is probably one of the most unique Disney classics out there because it has a lot of realism to it, minus the talking mice, of course, but the fact that we see a villain that is very terrifying because of how real she is, and the fact that a kidnapping is something that definitely happens in real life, because, once again, talking mice is fantasy, but the whole situation that these talking mice are thrown into is as real as it can possibly get, and of course Don Bluth was behind this movie, and The Rescuers Down Under is also fantastic as well. It was part of the Disney Renaissance, and it is probably one of the most underappreciated films in the Disney canon library. Number 7 is Atlantis: The Lost Empire. Now, I always remembered loving this movie, but when I saw it for the first time, when I reviewed it on my channel, it really was that much more incredible. And it's also because of the fact that Michael J. Fox voices the hero, Milo. I love Milo because he is a nerd, but he is a nerdy Indiana Jones. He wants to find Atlantis. He knows that if he does that, he will put himself in the history books as one of the greatest explorers of all time. The movie itself is a roller coaster ride. Excellent action, great villains, a great cast that supports Milo, and even if it doesn't have the typical Disney formula, because at that time, Disney was really thinking outside the box to give us some very new and exciting stories, we truly get a fantastic film that is worthy of being in the Disney library. Number 6 is The Hunchback of Notre Dame, probably one of the most unusual choices for Disney to make, especially in the middle of the Disney Renaissance, to give us a story that is so real and so heartfelt and sometimes even cruel to watch sometimes, especially considering the fact that the hero Quasimodo, while he may look ugly on the outside, he truly is filled with joy and love on the inside, but when you see him and he is under the watch of Judge Claude Frollo, Frollo is probably one of the most sinister villains that you can see on Disney classic screen, and some of the things that he does are absolutely disturbing and devastating, things that you would never even imagine that Disney would even give in terms of putting together an animated film. It is so well done, the animation is incredible, the music is wonderful, and just seeing the CGI work that gave us the massive crowds of people and the beautiful scope of Notre Dame Cathedral was an absolutely incredible thing to see. It is a movie that more people really need to revisit because it truly is a landmark in Disney animation. Number 5 has become one of my favorites. Every single time I watch it, it's like a fine wine. It only gets better. And it's The Great Mouse Detective. Basil of Baker Street is such a fantastic hero. He may have an ego the size of the globe, but he is the true epitome of good, going up against the true epitome of evil, which is also one of my favorites in all of Disney canon, Radigan. This character is just such a fun watch. He is brilliant, he is kooky, he is adventurous, he is true. And because of the fact that we get a character like this, we get such an incredible adventure. Something that's not necessarily as lighthearted as some of the Disney films in the past, but definitely one of the most underappreciated Disney classics ever. I guarantee you that if you haven't seen this movie in a while, and you're more of an adult at this point in time, you'll definitely see something truly special in The Great Mouse Detective. Number 4 is actually a movie that I haven't even reviewed on my Out of the Vault series yet, because quite frankly, when I finally run out of classics to review, until I have to wait for the new ones to come out, I kind of want to save the best for last. And it's the second Disney animated classic from 1940, Pinocchio. Pinocchio is the innocence in all of us. He is the journey that we all take to becoming the pure, happy soul that we venture to be ever since the day that we're born till the day that we die. Pinocchio is a story that gives you hope, wishing for your dreams to come true, and knowing that if you do prove yourself to be brave, truthful, and unselfish, you will find that eternal happiness that you are seeking. And of course, When You Wish Upon a Star, which is one of the most noteworthy Disney songs of all time, probably one of the most well-known in all of cinema, it has become the theme song of Disney as a whole, because that is what Disney set out to do, to make your dreams come true. Number three is Treasure Planet. I saw this movie for the very first time this year, and my God, was I missing something truly special. What an amazing adventure. Right up there with some of the movies that I have talked about in this video today. Jim Hawkins is also not the perfect person out there, but he definitely has a pure heart, and because of the fact that he's imperfect, we relate to him so much. The relationships that he has with all the characters, even the villain in this movie, is such an interesting relationship, and this movie itself is just so much fun. It's so entertaining. It's epic. It's such an amazing twist from John Musker and Ron Clements' take on Robert Louis Stevenson's Treasure Island. Treasure Planet is a true winner, everybody. If you haven't seen it yet, you really should, because it's incredible. Number two is one of the most recent Disney classics, and I think it's probably one of the most brilliantly written Disney classics in many, many years, and that's Zootopia. And of course, you don't have just one. You gotta throw in Judy Hopps and Nick Wilde. First of all, Jennifer Goodwin and Jason Bateman playing off each other is magic. It is such a great dynamic, and I love how the two of them mesh. But the story itself is so beautifully written. It is one of the most important stories ever told in Disney canon up until this point. It is such a great film with a true lesson to be learned that plays well into today's society, as well as even society from the past. It is a movie that I feel that all young kids need to see, because they will definitely get something from it. But not to mention the fact that the sophisticated humor, as well as the humor that is engaging towards children, this movie is a perfect package for both kids and adults. And that brings me to the number one film, and it could be debatable, but my favorite in this top 10 list outside of Fantasia is Wreck-It Ralph. The fact that we finally got video game culture in a Disney film was something that, of course, I couldn't be more excited for. And the fact that we got a great story of a villain named Ralph, who really is not a bad guy. He just wants to be a good guy and prove that he is a hero. And of course, you have to include Vanellope in there, who is also one of the most amazing characters in all of Disney, regardless of whether you like Sarah Silverman or not doing her voice. But the two of them are such a pair, and they are just such an enjoyable watch. The movie itself is just so funny, so innovative, and yes, I will even include Ralph Breaks the Internet, because that movie just took the first one and just hyped it up tenfold. It was such a great sequel, and I loved the story so much as a whole. I cannot recommend Wreck-It Ralph enough, and that is why it has been at my number two slot ever since I saw it for the very first time. As much as I would have loved to see a movie like Zootopia take it down to number three, there's just something about this movie that I love so dearly. And that's it, everybody. Those are my 10 favorite Disney canon classics and their heroes. I'm really looking forward to seeing what my collaborators have in store, because of course it's a blind box as always, and I'm looking forward to seeing you guys for the next episode of 10 for 12, because it's a reoccurring theme, and I'm sure you're all excited if you know which one it is. But in the meantime, I will see you in the next one. Hey, thank you so much for stopping by my channel today. If you're new here and want to see more of what my channel has to offer, please click on the link to my last video, or hit that subscribe button to be kept up to date with all of my uploads. Content of all sorts is posted here quite often, so trust me, you do not want to fall behind. I will see you in the comments, and actions speak louder than words.